Hey guys, be sure to like and subscribe. Today we got some new guidelines. They're soon to be released by the PRA. We got approved to put it out. And the PRA will put up the new guidelines soon. So you will be seeing this on their website pretty soon. And this is the new guidelines. If you put up your $1,400 application fee to start the process and your security deposit, and then you quit afterwards, you will lose your $1,400 application fee. So I just want you guys to be aware of that, okay? Now, I'm gonna explain to you why that's probably happening. And this is just my guess because of what I see happening with some people. They're asking really strange questions and I know what's behind it, but these guys are the guys that usually wreck it for everybody else. And they always come to the surface here. And what these guys do, and I've hung up on a few of these guys, they ask me, hey Steve, if I start the process, I get my EED and I get the 9A and then I get all approved to come into the Philippines and I get to the Philippines and I tell the PRA that I no longer want to do the SRRV visa. Will I get everything back? Well, the answer is no. You'll lose your $1,400 application fee, okay, but you'll have your security given back to you. So you'll lose the $1,400. This is to stop people from playing games, because there's a lot of people out there that play games as usual. We've talked about these people in the past before, and I just want people to be aware of that. You don't want to start this process and then stop it. It's a very daunting process to go through this and to put all these people through all this work. And you know, Mary Rose, our agent that we use on this channel, she only gets $500. So like for you to go halfway through three quarters of the way through the process, or even more, 90% through the process, and then quit, you know, she loses all that time. So you're just wasting my time and the agent's time, and it's not right. It's not fair. Okay, but I want to put that out there again. New guidelines soon to be released by the PRA. PRA will put up the new guidelines soon. And again, the guideline is, you lose your $1,400 application fee if you back out of the process. So as soon as you put that $1,400 in, you're in, okay? You're started. And if you guys are serious, you wanna get that in as soon as possible. You will get the security deposit back if you cancel it later on. But I just want you guys to know that, okay? Here's the other thing, guys. Me and Mary Rose are swamped right now, okay? I just want people to be aware of that, okay? We're swamped, emails, phone calls, everything. And guys, when you call me and you leave a message on my phone, I really don't listen to the messages. Just keep calling me till you get me, because I don't listen to the messages that people leave me most of the time. Sometimes I do if I'm expecting a call, but otherwise I really don't, because I have like 10 calls on there sometimes, and I just don't have like a half an hour to listen to each person's story, because some people leave big stories on there and I have to listen to it for like, you know, 2 or 3 minutes or whatever, and it just wastes my time, and I don't have that time. Also, guys, keep your emails pretty brief if you can, okay? I have people telling me their life stories. I don't have time for life stories. I really seriously don't. It just takes my time up. I just ask people to put in there exactly what you're looking for, your questions and things like that. If there's a lot of questions, I ask you to call me. So just ask for my phone number, okay? And we'll talk that way, because a lot of you guys send like a ton of questions, and some of these questions are pretty in-depth that you go into. And I'm not even sure if some of you guys are serious with some of the questions that you're giving me, because some of them are pretty crazy. But some of you guys are getting ahead of yourself too. And don't do anything until you talk to Mary Rose and get this started, because there's a lot of things going on. If you have something on your police report or something like that, it could become an issue. Okay, I want you guys to be aware of that. Okay, and the other thing is, when you're doing the EED, even if you're over 70, you still need your police reports, okay, for the EED. Just FYI, I'm not sure if that needs to be apostilled or not. I'm not quite sure. I don't think it does, but you can talk to Mary Rose about that, and she'll answer that question on the flip side. I answer stuff about apostilles and police reports pretty much, but I'm pretty sure if you're over 70, I think you just need the police report, but I'm not sure about the apostille, but you may want to run that by her. Okay, guys? So, guys, if you're trying to call me, keep calling me. You will get through. I do take a break every once in a while, and when some days I'll just shut down everything and just say, you know, hey, I'm going to go take a break. I'm going to go to the Mall of Asia, or I'll take a 3/4 of a day off or something like that or whatever. And, you know, sometimes we need a break too. So, because we get calls even on Sundays, Okay, people call us even on Sundays, and they call us Sunday nights. They call us in the morning sometimes. We've got people calling me in the middle of the night. I only want phone calls from people between 5 and 9 at night, Manila time, okay? And I've told a few people, if you really need to get in touch with me, you can call me after 12 noon all the way up till 9 at night. But I don't guarantee that I'll answer during the day, okay? Because if I'm riding around or if I'm doing something, sometimes I don't hear the phone ringing. But if you guys, you know, you need to get in touch with me, it's really important or something like that, call me. Call me after 12 noon. But do not call me in the middle of the night, guys. I won't answer, okay? Just remember that, okay? And I'm getting to the emails. I'm like about 2 days behind sometimes. I try to get to the comments as much as I can on the channel. So, you know, we try to keep up with that. Mary Rose is inundated too. So if you guys are trying to get in touch with Mary Rose, remember this. If you send her an email, give her at least 48 hours to get back to you. If she doesn't answer you, then write another email to her. But make sure in your heading you put looking to get EED to get the 9A to finish the SRRV application. Because that way there she knows you're serious. If you're gonna wait till they open up, then wait till they open up before you contact us, okay? That'll alleviate some of the problems because I have a lot of people that aren't going to be doing this for like a year or 6 months or something like that. Don't call us now because we're too busy for that right now. We're helping all these other people. It slows down the process more for everybody. Okay, I just want to let you guys know. Please don't contact us unless you want to get in here right now. We can get you in here fairly fast. Okay, I think it could be anywhere from 2 months to like 3.5 months tops, and you'll be in country probably, okay? With the EED, you get the 9A, and then you get the SRRV, okay? Now, I tell people, get in touch with Mary Rose first, okay? And I'll put her information in the description, okay? I'll put it in the description, and you can contact her. When you get done contacting her, shoot me an email at steven5975@yahoo.com and then ask me for my phone number. We'll have a talk and I'll get you started and we'll get you going and get everything rolling for you. Okay, so, and guys, be sure to watch my apostle video and watch my police report video. It's a ways back, but find those two and watch those, please. It's very important if you're gonna go through this process that you understand how to do apostles and you understand how to do the police report. Okay, so I just want you guys to understand a little bit of that. And that'll take some time off the phone calls too, guys, if you watch that. So please be aware of that. Okay, guys? Anyway, guys, God bless. Take care. And remember, keep on calling me. You will get through, guys. God bless. Take care.